So this is, you're going to get to this step, and then you can play around with all these little guys. When I first taught this, I taught it as young as like third grade for a watercolor activity, and we had all of them be cats. But you don't have to make them cats. I found this one, and I'll post this image. I don't know if you, oh, that's not it. I lost it. No! There it is. I found this image that is kind of in the same direction, only there's some, you know, it doesn't do like all Goalie's little loops. So I'm going to show you how you can use your pencil and then you can add and subtract to create something new. So if you were to just do a basically a basket of eggs kind of idea, I'll show you how to do that. But if you get a basket of eggs, then you can go in and then convert each of these in. You can make them into penguins, you can make them into hippopotamuses, any kind of animal that you want to. But I am going to show you in pencil, because a lot of times people start out with having a pencil and it's kind of easier to do that. Let me see if this one will show up better than the other one. Okay, so this, I don't normally tell kids to draw on the bottom of their paper, but we're going to fill the whole paper up to a certain amount, like up at the top, leave air, like there's a space above it where there's nothing up there. So I'm just going to do the traditional arches, which is, think of it as mouse holes. Think about a finger width high. If you go really tiny, you got a lot to fill with, and it makes it really hard. So the first one, move fast enough to do that. If you drag really hard, it's not gonna be that way. And then I do another one right next to it. And it kind of looks like toes of an elephant. And then this one, I'm not gonna go down, I'm gonna go off the page. And I'll do this one, I could probably just go right, I could do one where it kind of goes like this. So I'm just gonna let my finger go, and if it goes off the paper, or I'll just do that. So, and if you do this in pencil, you can then adjust it. If you do it in Sharpie, then it's quick and you can just make all your different animals. So I did this in Sharpie. So when I did this, I made sure that I was gonna end up doing what this one was. So then I'm gonna take, so that's your first step, is to do these little pieces. Put your thumb up if you've got this. Let me check and see if there's anybody waiting. I don't think anybody's waiting. Everybody seems to be waiting. Now, if you only have four, that's fine. If you only have three, that's fine. If you have 10, that's too many. So you're kind of like in a sweet zone about between three and five across. All right, I'm gonna do the next row. I'm gonna start from the top right here, and I'm gonna end up over here. Get lazy and just go like this. You wanna go like this. Think of it as a roller coaster. You want a fun roller coaster. You don't wanna have a roller coaster that doesn't do anything. So I'm gonna go up and down. Oh, and down. Up and off. Up and off. So now I have two rows. And they're kind of averaging about the same. That's good. So your first row and your second row should end up being about the same. So then I'm going to do that again. I'm going to start in the middle of one and end up in the middle of one. So I go up and over. Up and over. Other than a basket of eggs, what does this start to look like?
Kind of like the petals of a flower, but...
Yeah? What else do you think overlaps like this?
A hill?
Could be. But these are really uniform, aren't they?
Eggs,
but what else? Think of like the surface of a texture of a surface of a skin of some sort. What would that look like?
Oh yeah, dragon skins.
Mm-hmm. So if you want to do dragon
like scales.
They're like scales, fish, lizards, snakes. This would be a way. And what was that again?
Chameleons.
Chameleons, yes.
Bearded dragons.
Yes, exactly. Now, I would definitely go and look at those a little differently because their skin, like the bearded dragon and the chameleons, their skin is a little different than, say, a snake and some other chameleons and other lizards. They are tougher, and they don't seem to have those little flakes like that. It depends on the lizard. Okay, so I'm going to do again. Start from the middle and work over. Now, I didn't quite make it to the center. That's okay, as long as I make it to the center to the other side. Now, I've reached a moment where I can make a decision on whether I stop or keep going. So if you look up here, there's a lot of space. I could do another one, or I could make that look like sky. On this one, I went higher. Do you see how this one goes a little higher? This one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. This one has 1, 2, 3, 4 rows. So 4 or 5. Notice it's about the same as you going across. So this one, I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. So they kind of variate. There was variations. So don't worry if you don't have it completely the same number every single time. I think I will do another row because I may not use them all. Oh, I'm getting lazy. Mine got shorter, so I got a little lazy there. Okay, so that's a full page. You have all of these little guys have to become something. You can make them all the same animal, or you can change them up and make them into something else. That's what I like about this, is that it's really a fun way to do that. If you have Sharpies, if you have two size Sharpies, like you've got the regular Sharpie and then you have this size Sharpie, that'll be a fun way to outline it. If you have the microns, the 5 is probably equal to this Sharpie, okay? And then I did show you in the video, I had some brushes, like this one's a brush. I think this one's a brush. Nope, that's a 2. I know this one's a brush. So you can play around with your tools. You do not have to duplicate my tools, okay? So I'm going to go down really close and I'm going to take and make one of these into a cat. I'm going to make that one. Okay, I'm going to make that one into a cat. And I can do it with a pencil. If you're not sure about what you're doing, you can start with a pencil and then come back with a Sharpie. So I'll do that. I'm going to go and do the triangle for the nose. Here's the his eyes. And I have ears.
There you are.
Now I'm going to do and do a little bit of an outline. I'm going to use the technique of having the outline being big and the inside line being, some of the inside lines being smaller. So now, you do not have to go and do it this way. You can go and completely do it with just a Sharpie and not have to redraw. But some of you might want to do that just because you want to do some things a little differently. So, like, I want this to be a little bit thicker. I don't like the way that looked, so I'm going to come back over just a little bit thicker. And like I said, you can make some changes. This does not have to look perfectly like mine. I'm going to do a dog next. Okay. This time I'm going to do it completely with the Sharpie and without using the other one. So I'm going to do this one. Okay, so here's his ears. You know, they have all kinds of different ears, so you can go and play around with the ears a little bit. I'm going to thicken that up a little bit. If you have thicker markers, this is fun to do. Now I'm gonna do his eyes and nose. Now remember, his nose is gonna be different than a cat's. Almost like a little mushroom. Then he has round eyes. And then he has pupils. That are pretty big. Fill those out.
Can we get on the bed, right?
Now you can change the way he looks. If you put cats all the way around him, he'd get all nervous, right? And then he would like, do I want to be here? Because there's all these cats. Or you can make him really happy. And he's real happy. He's sticking his tongue out and just going, I'm so happy, I'm so happy. I get to be around all these kitty cats. And they do have whiskers, but not the same as cats. Thank you. a terrible thing to say.
Because I think I,
You think my ideas?
Yeah, I think I got way too many.
Nope, that's fine. I'd rather have too many than not enough. Can you imagine what that life would be like?
No, actually, I put too many.
Oh, too many little guys?
Well, see?
If you did, no, you're good. I want it to, you figured out some different ways to do it, and that's what I want you to do. So that's why I want you, I would love to see what you guys end up with. Just because I can't walk around the room with you guys. And that's why I want you guys posting pictures. So that I can see what you did. So right now I'm going to finish this on my own and get it so that we can use it to do watercolor. Are at 12:32 and I believe I am done.